February 25th, 9:37 a.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 2. This is Defendant Lobby, alright, but there's no defendant. I've been trying to reach Lana all morning. Where could she be? What do you mean, have you been trying to reach her? Hasn't she been in jail? Where else would she be other than in jail? Okay? Where's Emma, for that matter? It almost seems as if... something's been happening behind the scenes. Question mark. Oh, Edgeworth! Hey, boo-boo, how you doing? Knowing you, you've already figured it out. Who the owner of the 777777 ID number is, that is. Well, I have a pretty strong hunch. Oh, looks like I'm not the only one who's figured it out. You know, the only reason this trial didn't reach a verdict yesterday, because there was still room for doubt regarding this ID card. That number does belong to whom you suspect, and no doubt will remain. After all, he hasn't been officially charged with anything. True. Not yet. In any event, once all doubt has been removed from that list, I can call for a ruling. 5 minutes, right? Chief Prosecutor Sky will be found guilty. But she didn't do it! I figured you'd say as much. That's why I came here. To hear what you have to say. This is the first time he's ever done something like this. Is our relationship going... serious? Lana's hiding something, and the only way we'll ever know the truth is to draw it out of her. The truth? Everything goes back to the SL9 incident. Don't be stupid. Today's the last day of the trial. We don't have time to reminisce about the past. You dumbass, it's not reminiscing. It's trying to connect the pieces. I still love this one guard, like, in the first background, just being like, "Oh, look at them chatting. How cute." That depends on you. If she's found guilty, you'll lose your only chance to find out what really happened. I'll think about it. See you in court, right? And later, my place. I can't, there we go, there's my snapping. I've failed the first snap. It's fine. I imagine it's Edgeworth being super awkward and not knowing how to be like, hey. This is it. If I'm ever going to find out what Chief Gant has over her, I am inserting my own words. If I'm ever going to find out what Chief Gant has on her, it's now. Bum, bum, bum. It is now 10 a.m. and it's District Court, courtroom number 9. Oh. Holy shit, is it the last day? I sure hope so. 3 days is too long for a trial.
Court is now in session for the trial of Miss Lana Sky.
Defense is ready, Your Honor.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
Normally, this is where the prosecution puts forth its opening statement.
What do you mean? Normally? Excuse me?
But before that, the police chief has a proposal to make.
Chief. Oh, what if Lana was missing because Chief Gant went to go talk to her and be like, you better keep up your blackmail part of the deal or whatever it was. There's some blackmail going on. I fucking bet you. Something's happening.
Chief Gant.
Hello. You make me uncomfortable. Oh, and then folks, how's everyone doing? Hey, Edgy. Been back to the pool yet?
Oh, I've been drowning enough as it is in my work. Oh, that's a good one. Don't think I can top that.
If you don't mind me asking, Chief, exactly what is this proposal of yours.
He's gonna be like, make her guilty now, and let's be done with it.
Lana, that is to say, the defendant, has asked me if she could speak directly to the court. She wants to do what? Having heard what she intends to say, I feel she should be granted her request. In the end, it should save everyone a lot of time and trouble. She's gonna say she's guilty. She's gonna say she's guilty. And I have to be like, no, you're wrong. What's this all about, defendant? I'd just like to make one simple request, and I'll be finished.
Well then, what's your request?
Find me guilty. Your Honor, I'd like you to put an immediate end to this trial.
Huh?
I confess to all charges against me. On February 21st of this year, I murdered Detective Bruce Goodman in the underground parking lot of the prosecutor's office.
No, Lana, you dumbass!
Wait, hasn't the preacher said she was guilty from the start?
Holy shit, so much is happening. You can't!
Your Honor, the defendant's claim does not change the defense's plea. In that case, Mr. Wright, I no longer require your services.
But Lana!
Your Honor, I hereby forfeit my right to an attorney. The prosecution may lack direct evidence against me, but it has sufficiently proven its case through testimony and circumstantial evidence. I would like you to render your verdict now, if you please.
Well, the defendant certainly has the right to self-representation. The request is legally valid, although this is an unprecedented situation. Indeed, it appears there's no further need to continue this trial.
Hold on, wait, is the game just over? I doubt it's actually over, but like, damn, imagine if actually, like, okay, cool, that was the fifth trial. Hope you had fun. Like, come again.
Even if Mr. Wright may feel otherwise.
This can't be happening.
It appears the time for the verdict has arrived. This court finds the defendant.
Objection!
Oh, my boo-boo to the rescue. Oh, thank fuck.
One moment.
Sorry. Wrong voice.
One moment, Your Honor.
But Mr. Edgeworth?
The prosecution has not yet proven the defendant guilty beyond reasonable doubt. Any ruling at this stage would certainly be premature.
Come now, Worthy. I understand this is a difficult time for you. Why don't you just be a good little boy and keep your mouth shut? How is none of this sketchy now? Come on!
I don't think I care for your tone, Chief Gant.
Shots fired!
What? Create another fabrication to cover up your past mistakes? Sorry, but I'm no longer the naive little boy you would have me be. With this sudden confession from the defendant, it's obvious to me some kind of deal was struck behind the scenes.
Some kind of deal, Not everyone operates as you do, Worthy.
Listen, those were his past mistakes. We're working on it together. It's a work in progress.
I thought so.
Your Honor, the prosecution would like to change its first witness.
Oh? Ho-ho!
As its first witness, the prosecution would like to call Miss Emma Skye. I request the court hears her testimony.
Oh, it's Lana who said that. Oh.
Mr. Edgeworth, I am exercising my right to self-representation. I don't think we need to continue.
I don't care what you think, Miss Skye.
The exposure of truth sometimes results in tragedy. However, no matter how tragic the truth may be, it would be an even greater tragedy to avert one's eyes from it.
Very well, the court shall grant the prosecution's request. That's okay with you, right, Chief Gunt?
Worthy, you'll live to regret this. Mark my words. Hello? Is no one gonna go? Wow, that is a threat. That is a threat in open court and being recorded. Maybe he's talking like he's so nice, like, oh, you'll regret this. But this is like, no, this is a fucking threat. Look at those weird eyeballs. It's a threat. Miss Emma Sky, please take the stand. Looks like Edgeworth has decided to take the horse by the reins. Now then, witness, please state your name and occupation.
My name is Emma. Emma Sky. My occupation? I'm Lana's little sister, and I want to be a scientific investigator.
A few years ago, you encountered the serial killer Joe Dark of the Joe Dark Killings. Is this correct?
Yes. I'm trying my hardest to forget about that, though. Thanks for bringing up my past trauma, bitch.
I'm sorry. But I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to recall those events one more time. Mr. Edgeworth, please remember this trial concerns the murder of Detective Goodman. Is an incident that was resolved 2 years ago really all that relevant?
Yes, it most certainly is. My boyfriend told me so. instinct.
Well, okay then.
He sure came in fast. Now, please testify about what happened to you 2 years ago.
The trip to yesteryear has finally begun.
It's bound to lead to the truth behind this trial.
Dun, dun, dun.
2 years ago,
I was waiting in my sister's office that day. A man came running in and took me hostage. Neil Marshall rescued me. And I'll never forget what I saw in that instant. The man raised up his knife and stabbed Mr. Marshall in the chest.
Do I already have shit that would contradict that? Hold on. I feel like there was something weird last time I noticed about like the way he was stabbed. Like, it didn't look right. Okay, yeah. But it's something weird about the way they're standing and the way he ends up. There's weird shit going on. Single stab wound piercing in the heart/lung. Died from blood loss in under 10 minutes. Weapon found in wound was missing tip. Which, that was weird. But I think because the actual murder weapon is that missing sword, and that's why the current shield award thingies no longer have it. It's something. See, they don't have it anymore. Okay, I'm remembering what we talked about last time. Okay.
It's a good thing you weren't harmed.
Passed out. I don't remember much.
That's understandable. However, please tell me, Mr. Edgeworth, what does this testimony have to do with Detective Goodman's murder?
Wait, no, my theory's probably wrong. I'm gonna sit on my thoughts. I'm gonna sit on them for now.
That will soon become apparent, Your Honor. Right, Phoenix?
I admire him for his courage, considering he has no evidence.
Very well. Defense may begin. It's cross-examination.
Alright, I'm really not sure. I guess I'll just press on shit for now, because I'm not 100% sure. Hold on. Let me save first. That'll be the smart thing to do. And then, I don't know if there's anything contradictory of note. I'm does have any reason to lie. Alana sure does. I need to get Emma to tell me as much as she can. Okay. Yeah, so I'm just gonna press shit. 2 years ago, the defendant was a detective at the police department, correct?
Yes, she was second in command under the deputy chief of police, Gant. My sister, she was the best detective ever.
Yes, I remember. Deputy Chief Gant and Miss Guy used to be quite the pair.
I believe they share the same office.
That's right. I'd always sit at my sister's desk and dream about playing that organ. I wanted to play it that day, too.
The police department and the prosecutor's office held a ceremony that day.
Lana promised to take me to dinner after she finished her work.
Man came running in and took me to the stage. Man?
Yes, Joe Dark. He was a serial killer.
Joe Dark was brought in for questioning on the day of that ceremony. We were desperate to get anything on him that would lead to an arrest.
When he saw his chance, he fled the room, right?
Upon fleeing the room, Dark proceeded to take the elevator. He must have been in a panic because the elevator was going up. Then he ran into Sky and Gant's office.
There was a lot of noise coming from outside, so I opened up the door to have a look. That's when I saw him.
Neil Marshall rescued me.
What was the prosecutor doing there?
That day, there were two people presenting during Dark's questioning.
Present?
Did I say presenting? I don't know what the fuck I said. Sorry, I swear I'm trying.
Deputy Chief Damon Gant and Prosecutor Neil Marshall.
Almost forgot about Gant.
How do you forget about the most suspicious man?
Okay. Neil Marshall had just received the King of Prosecutors Award. Yep, have that photo. A lot of sharp things in that area. Young and dedicated, he went straight to the questioning room after the ceremony.
I assume that would also be why he was the first to run after Dark.
Dark grabbed me. I thought I was good as dead.
That's when Prosecutor Marshall came running in.
I don't clearly remember what happened then, but
forget what I saw in that instant.
Can you tell us about that?
Mr. Marshall jumped on Dark. Just then, the lights went out.
The lights?
It was just about this time of year. There was a terrible storm going on, and lightning struck nearby.
So the electricity went out?
Wait a minute. It was pitch dark in that room. You shouldn't have been able to see anything, right?
Right, but just then lightning flashed again outside. That sudden flash left an unforgettable image in the scene of my mind.
I see.
I told the detective about what I saw then.
The detective?
Yes, Detective Goodman. He was in charge of the case.
Detective Bruce Goodman, victim.
Hear more. So you spoke with Detective Goodman about this 2 years ago. Yes, that's what's so scary about this trial.
And you told Detective Goodman about what you saw?
Yes, but at the time, words just wouldn't come out. That's why I drew a picture.
Picture?
Yes, I think she mentioned that before.
Well, Mr. Wright, have you heard enough?
Ask about the picture.
This picture, the witness trail. I believe it has a very important meaning.
Objection!
The list of evidence I was given 2 years ago didn't contain a picture. Witness, would you mind if we added this statement to your testimony?
Yes, Your Honor.
The picture of that scene was, but it seems to have been lost.
Didn't I get it? I swear I've fucking seen it. I saw it somewhere. Where the fuck did I see it? Am I crazy? I feel like I've seen the picture. wasn't in here, was it? Come there. Wait a minute, hold on. Oh, it's just a plate.
I knew I saw it. Do it.
Let me save though.
Just cause I'm a scaredy cat. Okay. Shit. Present.
Mr. Edgeworth. This little girl put all her heart into drawing that picture. And yet, you would insist on denying its existence?
Huh? Hey, I'm not the bad guy!
Sorry, old habits.
All I'm saying is that as the prosecutor for that case, I wasn't handed such a picture.
That may well be. That doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
Behold!
This is evidence list from the SL9 incident.
Please turn it over, Your Honor.
Turn it over? Ah! What's this?
It's that picture!
Oh, you can see the weapon's kind of weirdly, like, rectangle shape. So showing that it wasn't pointy at the end. Maybe. Or maybe just a rough sketch of, here's where a knife should be.
Yes, what is that? Hey, that's it! That's the picture I drew!
Holy shit, why is a drawing on the back of an evidence list?
Indeed, two men appear to be wrestling here.
Objection. What's the meaning of this? What are you doing with that list?
Me?
Only the prosecutor in charge should have access to that list.
Huh? These lists, they're different from each other.
What?
It would appear, Mr. Edgeworth, that the evidence list you were handed 2 years ago was incomplete.
Gant was hiding the true evidence list.
Oh, shit.
These two lists fit together to form one. You can see the marks here, where they were torn apart from each other.
So you see, Mr. Edgeworth, it's quite obvious what happened. Gant is a motherfucker. Sorry. 2 years ago, only half of the evidence in that case ever reached you.
What?
Gosh, what a poorly done trial.
Order, order. Oh, Miss Sky, why did you draw your picture on the back of such an important list?
Because that's what Detective Goodman handed me in the questioning room, Your Honor. Wait a minute. This list was torn in half. Then that means...
Your Honor.
Are you all right, Mr. Wright? Your eyes are bulging from your head.
I've just had a revelation. Don't mind me, sir. If the evidence list was torn in half, there might be more of the drawing on the back of Mr. Edward's list.
Is there going to be... Did she draw two pictures? Did she draw...
Yes, that's quite conceivable, Mr. Edward.
It's possible. Let's see.
Is something wrong? It's like you duct taped your mouth shut.
You even have to ask?
Sorry, Your Honor. There is indeed something drawn on the back of my list. It's that thing.
Gonna be seen as fucking important? Is it finally?
That thing that was dancing in the evidence room.
Clearly, this act of vandalism is the work of a certain chief of detectives. Guess he was out of scrap paper. Or she drew it because she saw it there.
she gonna remember? Evidence list restored and updated in the court record. Hold on, can I see it as a whole, please? That doesn't... So they're assuming right now that someone else drew on it and it wasn't her. But I think it was her, but I'm trying to figure out, did she see it in the corner of the room? Because I assumed it was going to be one complete picture, but it looks like, for now, two separate things. Or maybe a shadow reflected on the... No, that doesn't make sense either. I'm trying to think if it would be like a reflection or if it was like if that's meant to represent something else. I don't know. There's going to be something important about it. I just don't know what right now.
Very well, witness. Will you please testify about this picture you drew 2 years ago?
Huh? Oh! Yes, sir, Your Honor. I wonder if she's having, like, flashbacks. What's wrong with Emma? She seemed to be thinking about something when she was looking at the picture. Emma's picture! Save. Oh, no, I have to click first. Actually, I'll wait till after. This is the picture I drew 2 years ago. The flash of lightning was so bright, all I could see were shadows. After that, I must have fainted. This picture shows exactly what I saw in that instant.
Not a lot to go off of, Emma. Come on.
Excuse me.
You think a flash of lightning could burn such an image in your mind?
Thanks to that, though, she was able to show us exactly what she saw.
Well, I don't see any contradictions here. This clearly shows Joe Dark about to murder Prosecutor Neil Marshall.
Unless there's something fishy about what she saw.
The defense may now begin its cross-examination.
This picture... We're gonna save... So far, I'm not quite sure what we want out of this. Did you draw this picture right after the incident? I think I drew it 2 or 3 days later. At first, I was in such a state of shock that I couldn't do anything. During that time, the investigation team was reorganized. Detective Goodman was placed in charge under the direction of Damon Gant and Lana Skye. 2 or 3 days later, memory should have still have been fresh in her mind.
Excuse me, witness. Can you please tell us why this picture is painted all black?
The flash of lightning was so bright, all I could see were shadows. So at the time, you didn't even know it was Mr. Marshall who had come to your rescue? No, I couldn't see him clearly. Lightning was so bright, and I was knocked to the floor. You were knocked to the floor? Dark had a tight grip on me, but when Mr. Marshall jumped on him, I was knocked away. I turned around, and that's when the lightning flashed. Poor Emma. I'm just glad she wasn't hurt. What happened after the lightning flashed? After that, I must have fainted. You mean you didn't see the actual murder take place? No, I'm sorry. The flash of lightning only drove off the darkness for a split second. Not only that, but the trauma of the situation understandably caused the witness to faint.
Do you really need to torture this girl any further? Sorry, I'm just trying to get information.
What? Hey, I'm not the bad guy here! Where have you heard that one before? Anyway, this picture shows exactly what I saw in that instant.
Hold it!
Sorry for asking so many times. Are you sure you drew exactly what you saw? Of course! This is the exact scene! It wasn't influenced in any way from your talks with the detectives? Are you insinuating we somehow manipulated her memory, Mr. Wright? No, no, of course not. Better watch out or he might find some way to cut my salary. I drew this picture before I heard anything from the detectives, so I don't think anyone's story would have influenced me.
Mr. Wright? Is there something that's bothering you about this picture?
Huh? Oh, well... That's strange. She claims this is exactly the scene that was imprinted in her mind. And yet, there's clearly a contradiction. Is it the arm blocking the chest? Oh shit, I don't know what the book this game wants from me. What am I supposed to present? I think it's maybe some, like, how did he get stabbed in the chest if his arm was up? Maybe that's what they're trying to go for. I'm not 100% sure though. And plus there's that other part of the picture too, which I think it has to mean something. I think it was in the office. I'm gonna try see. Topsy?
Objection! Oh! Apparently that was it. I kind of pulled that out of my ass. Not gonna lie.
I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but this picture the witness drew contains a blatant contradiction. What? I still remember it like it was yesterday.
Mr. Wright, you better not be bullying this child. Perhaps it would be faster if you simply pointed out this contradiction for us. What part of this picture contradicts the autopsy report?
It's gonna be his... Well, okay, they kind of went straight for it, but like his arm.
Take that!
Okay, good. I think it's... this part here?
I don't see what's so strange about that.
That's because the drawing stinks! Am I gonna lose? Did I not point at the right place? Or is this actually how this game's gonna go? Mr. Wright, how could you? The act of making an innocent girl cry should warrant the death penalty. Wait. So it's not the arm blocking the chest? I mean, Edgeworth's right. Okay, that's so weird. The music stopped like I said it right. I guess he means I shouldn't shift the blame to others.
Yes, well, so long as the defense has learned his lesson.
Taking a look at the pen. Mr. Wright. Okay. What, the weapon then being like square? Is this what we're talking about? My answer's correct. I think mine was correct too, but apparently not. Apparently we don't know anything about defensive wounds or how that works. Like, okay, whatever. The contradiction, of course, lies here. Take a look at the knife the man is holding. If you look closely, you can see its tip is broken.
Even I don't have to look closely to see that, Mr. Wright.
But Mr. Wright, look at the evidence. See the murder weapon? Its tip is broken too.
If I recall, the tip of the knife was found broken off in the victim's body.
It was the conclusive piece of evidence that proved Joe Dark was the murderer. I'm afraid it's not so simple, Emma.
Objection!
What the fuck are you talking about?
And where, pray tell, could you possibly see a problem? It's obvious, really. The victim suffered a single stab wound to the back. What the fuck? Where does it say to the back? Did this game mistranslate? Cause of death. Single stab wound piercing. Heart/lung. I'm reading this right, right? Yeah, there's no other way to read this. Single stab wound piercing heart/lung. Died from blood loss in under 10 minutes. Weapon found and wound was missing tip. Victim suffered a single... Where did it say a single stab wound to the back? I wonder if this was a last stream episode thing. Because I think... I don't remember this. But I think they were showing how he was found. And he was on his back. And I think that was the weird thing I was pointing out. Because he's doing this... And somehow he ends up like this instead of like, like straight back. There was some, okay. Doesn't help that the autopsy doesn't fucking say that it was through the back. It said heart, lungs. So my brain automatically went, oh, you get to the heart through here or the lungs through here. But I guess technically you could get to there through the back. Okay. If the victim was only stabbed once, then the murder weapon should not yet be broken. Oh, I see the logic. Like, why is it already broken off when it was then found inside the body? It should have broken it. I'm catching up. I was almost there, but I wasn't quite there. Okay.
What's the meaning of this?
Perhaps the knife was broken beforehand.
Objection.
Then why is it in the body? Sorry, but I'm afraid that's not possible. The tip of the knife was found inside the victim's body. If it was broken beforehand, it couldn't possibly wind up there.
That's right. What does that mean?
Oh my gosh, everyone's interrupting each other. The tip of the knife was undeniably discovered within the victim's body. The only possible explanation is the witness's memory is mistaken.
Objection.
That's why I asked her so many times if she was sure she remembered correctly. I believe you were annoyed at the time,
if I recall.
But she was sure she remembered correctly.
But there's no other way to explain this inconsistency.
Objection.
Not so fast, Mr. Edgeworth. There is another explanation. Have you forgotten already? About a little something called falsified evidence?
You're treading on thin ice, right? Not in the mood.
All I'm saying is that this broken knife tip might be the piece of evidence that was forged. You can't deny the possibility.
No.
Ah!
What if they broke the knife, so then it also looked like the sword part of the award? So you couldn't tell the difference. So otherwise someone would have figured out, oh, he was stabbed with the award. And then they just, whoever, like, kind of like shoved the tip in there later or covered it in blood, probably shoved it in there or like covered in blood and was like, oh yeah, it was found in the body. I don't know. I'm jumping ahead. Let's just figure this out.
Order. Are you saying the investigation really was corrupted?
Your Honor, please allow me to once again go over the evidence that took place. Go over the events that took place the day of the murder. The police department and the prosecutor's office were holding a ceremony that day. After receiving the King of Prosecutors Award at the ceremony, Neil Marshall questioned Joe Dark along with Damon Gant.
Okay. I'm trying to... Okay. Maybe I'm going, like... way off. Way off. But... did she somehow... she saw this image, and it's some kind of shadow of something happening. So maybe this was, like, falling or being thrown or, like, somehow lifted. And, like, I don't know. Somehow this was used, and it somehow casted that shape. I'm not quite sure how. I kind of see it in, like, maybe the handles. I'm not quite sure where the third thing comes from. It comes from the bottom of the vase, top of the vase, or, like, again, I'm probably completely off. I don't know. This is just my wheels turning. And... so then somehow, no, because now I'm thinking like, oh, it influenced the creation of the badger. But I think the badger has just been part of the murder all along, because there's fucking handprints there and smudge and it's been broken. Like, I think it was just in the office that day, I think. But also, or somehow it's related to the Goodman murder. But maybe it was still influenced by what she saw with the vase, or maybe... I don't think this. I don't know. I'm probably getting ahead of myself. Oh, I accidentally skipped text, I think. It was something about he got the reward. Cool. Good for him. It's not important. During his questioning, Joe Dark fled the room. Prosecutor Marshall chased after him and was killed by Dark. It is my belief that somewhere in this story, there is a lie. I'm not lying. Man really was holding up a broken knife. If that's true, there's no other way around it. This could not have been the actual murder weapon. There must have been another broken knife. What are the chances of there being two broken knives? Another broken knife besides Joe Dark's. Would there have been one? I'm gonna do another save just in case. I don't know if there's an achievement for like never losing health or whatever. Just in case. I think there's another one. Witness is this adamant about the accuracy of what she saw. It can't just be explained away by a simple observational error. Mr. Wright. In that instant, Emma really did see a broken knife. It's from the fucking statue. The trophy.
I assume, then, that you have some information about this other broken knife? If so, please feel free to enlighten us.
The murder weapon was already broken prior to the murder. Only one way. Take a look at this. Here's the real murder weapon. Oh shit. Or do they want me? Is it gonna be injured? I think it's gonna be. It's gonna be. Oh, I'm sorry. I pressed the wrong button. Present. The answer lies in the past. 2 years in the past. Right here inside this picture. This is a picture of the award ceremony. Oh, wait, I'm sorry, that's Edgeworth.
This is a picture of the award ceremony.
I think he caught on.
What is it, Mr. Edgeworth?
It's the broken murder weapon. Notice the award prosecutor Marshall is holding? Alright, that was meant to be a statement, not a question. That's a broken knife. As we earlier concluded, the knife in the drawing was not Joe Dark's knife. That being the case, the knife the witness saw was in all likelihood from this award.
A knife from an award? How can that be? Order, order, order!
Neil Marshall was awarded King of the Prosecutors that day. As an award, he was given this broken shield and knife. When he chased after Joe Dark, he pulled out this knife. Oh, I would not have thought of that. Okay. Being a prosecutor, he did not carry a pistol. This broken knife was the only weapon he had in this dangerous situation.
But that can't be.
Oh? Why not, Mr. Edgeworth? because the Kingdom Prosecutor's war knife was the murder weapon. The murderer and the victim would be reversed.
What do you mean?
I mean, this man raising the knife would have been Prosecutor Neil Marshall.
Oh. Ow!
But the prosecutor was the one who actually died.
That's true. What's going on here?
It seems Mr. Wright has been a bit too eager to jump to conclusions.
Wait! I remember now! I remember everything!
Oh, thank fuck. Witness?
Mr. Edgeworth.
What is it?
Could you show me your evidence list again, please?
This list? The one with that picture scribbled on the back? Oh, we're gonna talk about it now.
Wait. This picture... I'm the one who drew it.
What?
You drew that? That's right. The list wasn't torn in half at the time I drew this picture. At this time, I've been trying so hard to... all this time, I've been trying so hard to forget. I must have locked this part away deep inside me.
Perhaps it would be best if we add this to the witness's testimony. Would you please tell us what you've recalled, Miss Guy?
Yes, Your Honor.
It's the knife mix-up, and now the blue badger? Should be interesting.
Emma's recollection. When I saw that man raise his knife, I panicked, and I rushed toward both of them. I think I knocked away the man with the knife. Just then, there was another flash of lightning. That's when I saw the blue badger. He wasn't in the room, but I'm sure I saw his shadow.
Okay, that cleared up nothing for me. What the fuck are you talking about, Emma?
This is certainly most unusual.
Objection!
Try impossible. The Chief of Detectives hadn't even designed him until this year.
That would mean he didn't even exist 2 years ago.
Yes, well, the defense may now begin its cross-examination.
Oh, she's getting desperate. That means something's up. We're getting closer to the truth.
Okay, hear me out.
This is the theory I was sitting on. I think I'm semi-confident enough to share this now. What if Emma was the one who killed Neil Marshall? Somehow, in the scuffle, in the confusion, she thought she was attacking Joe Dark, but accidentally actually killed Neil Marshall. And Gant is still somehow involved in shady business. I think something to do with Gant, with Joe Dark. I think Joe and Gant are related somehow. I mean, they have the same fucking eyes. But I'm wondering if Emma was the one who accidentally killed Neil, and that's why Gant has, like, his pressure over Lana to be like, if you don't do what I say, she's going to jail. Like, we will convict her, and she will go to jail, and her life's fucked. That's my theory. That's the one I tucked away earlier. But now I'm like wondering if, like, the way she was like, oh, I rushed up to them and I pushed someone away. I think something happened. Either that, or my next best guess would be Lana was told or somehow thinks Emma did kill Neil, but in all actuality, it was Gant who did. But he's saying, oh, it was Emma, sorry.
And then, same scenario. Blackmail, under thumb, you know. Sorry, okay. Stop, please, don't pursue this any further. Lana?
What's the meaning of this? Please remain seated in the defendant's chair.
But you can't do this. I've already confessed to the crime. Why can't you just leave it at that? Chief Prosecutor Sky. We've already come this far. It's too late to turn back.
Silence! The defense will now begin its cross-examination. Bailiff, please detain the defendant.
It seems we're finally getting to the core of the matter. Emma's recollection.
Are you sure about this? Of course! See? I even drew a picture of him here!
What? It was the chief detectives who thought of this hideous beast. And that was just this year. Blue Badger didn't exist 2 years ago. This is all quite verifiable.
That sounds strange. I was surprised too when I saw him at the police department. I had this nagging feeling that I'd seen him before somewhere. I finally remember!
Oh, brother, just when you thought that thing had caused enough commotion.
Tell us, where in the room did you see him dancing?
It's in the room, but I'm sure I saw his shadow.
Hold it!
His shadow? So you mean you didn't actually see his face with its winning smile and all?
That's right, but I still remember it. He had 3 creepy horns.
Pointless. That thing couldn't have possibly existed 2 years ago.
Witness must be mistaken.
Objection.
That may well be. But what's important is that what's important is what caused her to think she saw what she did.
Oh, and I suppose you have an explanation. If so, then by all means, please tell us what the shadow really was.
What was it Emma saw when that lightning flashed? Who is this Blue Badger, really?
I just might...
Blue Badger hadn't even been dreamt up when Emma drew this picture. Yet she's certain she saw its shadow.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is the defense's belief that on that fateful day 2 years ago, there indeed was something that looked similar to the Blue Badger. Something that is now sitting in this very room.
Mr. Wright!
In this room? Very well, Mr. Wright. What is it that the witness saw in that instant?
Say, just because I don't know. I think it's the face.
Mysterious Blue Badger lookalike.
Take that!
Mysterious Blue Badger was, in fact, this.
But that's... what exactly is that?
I believe it's some sort of jar. But Mr. Wright, that doesn't look anything like the Blue Badger.
Indeed it doesn't. As it stands now, it's just a plain jar. However, what if we were to change our viewpoint?
Our viewpoint?
We gotta show them the correct angle to look at this from. Oh gosh, they really, okay.
Well, is this a miracle or what?
Fucking is!
No one can possibly deny this jar's resemblance to the Blue Badger.
And bet your ass Gant had the creature made.
just in case that picture ever came up again. Or something.
Order, order! The defense has proven its claim. The mysterious blue badger witnessed on the day of the crime was actually this.
Objection!
Although we all enjoyed Mr. Wright's traumatic performance and multiple fuck-ups, one question remains.
What's your point? What do you mean?
So that badger thing was actually just a jar. That doesn't change anything.
Objection!
I'm afraid that's where you're wrong, Mr. Edgeworth. You see? This changes everything.
Indeed. Very well then, please tell us. What's different now that we know the witness saw this jar?
Murderer? Or the location? The location. That's my guess. But... Save! Allow me to take these in turn. At the moment of the murder, the witness saw this jar. At the very specific angle, I might add, Mr. Wright. Yes, well, knowing this, where could she have seen this jar?
Where?
The location of the jar is shown in a picture taken on the day of the crime. It's on a shelf in the office of Damon Gant.
Objection!
But the body was found lying near Lana Skye's desk. The witness testified so herself.
Objection!
Yes, and it is these two facts that reveal what actually transpired. You see, the struggle between Dark and Marshall did not take place in Nalana Sky's office. It happened on the other side of the room, in Chief Gant's office.
Objection!
Are you implying the murderer moved the victim's body?
From Damon Gant's office to Lana Sky's office?
I like how they're talking about that as if they're like two separate offices when they're really just different parts of the room.
Yes. Why would he do that? There's no reason.
Exactly.
If there wasn't a reason, he wouldn't have gone through the trouble. The only logical conclusion is that there was a reason.
Excuse me. You know what that reason was, Mr. Wright.
Gant is fucking guilty. Gant is fucking guilty. Finally figured it out. So this is why Lana tried to stop the trial. It's too late to quit now, though.
Please recall the witness's testimony. She said she knocked away the man who was holding up the knife. In the next instant, the jar was hit and flew through the air. Now tell me, what could have sent the jar flying?
That would have to have been the impact the man made when he was knocked into the wall.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I may draw your attention to this picture once more.
Oh, are they gonna say that? But then, I don't know, you would think the spear would then be the thing that stabbed someone, but
it's the broken knife thing. That spear is not broke. I don't know.
I feel like it's... The armor is gonna somehow be important, I'm sure. How?
I don't know.
If the man was knocked in the direction of the shelf the jar was sitting on, what would he have hit?
The suit of armor! Holding a very sharp and dangerous-looking sword.
Called a lance or a spear, but sure.
Yes. And since the man who was knocked into the armor was carrying a broken knife, would have had to have been Neil Marshall, holding the King of Prosecutors trophy.
No, Mr. Wright, you can't be thinking that.
Yes, there was another possibility of what actually transpired in that room.
Another possibility? Emma accidentally killed someone!
Of course, the perpetrator would have had no idea, but nevertheless.
Oh my god, with this.
Mr. Wright, what's the matter?
If events took place that the defense theorizes, then the outcome is obvious.
that moment, assuming the man Emma Sky knocked away was actually Prosecutor Neil Marshall.
Yeah.
You mean Mr. Marshall died because of... I never imagined her testimony would lead to this.
So it was the witness who took the victim's life. Then proved so with her own testimony. This is unprecedented!
I'd say it was more so than that. Wait, what are you saying? Sorry, Miss Sky, but given the circumstances, Joe Dark murdered Prosecutor Marshall. How can you think it was Emma? How dare you try to pin the crime on her? Okay, I'm sorry. I have to be honest. This particular angle of her portrait, not flattering. Like, it looks so weird. Imagine that coming from you.
That's different.
If you recall, it was you who admitted to forging evidence 2 years ago. The reason you moved Prosecutor Marshall's body was to keep anyone else from finding out about what Emma did, wasn't it? I assure you, Mr. Edgeworth, I have no idea what you're talking about. If you hope to have anyone believe your insane allegations, I'm afraid you're going to have proof. Tell me. Do you have any conclusive evidence that proves my sister killed Neil Marshall? Evidence? I'm willing to bet you don't.
Yes, it certainly would be difficult to prove this with evidence.
If we don't have evidence, then we'll have to rely on testimony. I'm afraid that won't work in this case. Both parties involved in the incident are dead. We certainly can't get dead people to testify. This has all been... It's funny to hear him say that because he's had, you know, his dead boss be channeled through Mia. Mia was the boss, Maya was the sister. Yep, okay. Jess, yep, okay. Silly me. This has all been a wild goose chase from the beginning. Touché, Miss Sky. Of course, that only leaves us with one possibility. You mean there's still another possibility?
What do you mean, Mr. Edgeworth?
I mean the possibility that the victim has left us a message. For better or for worse, Mr. Marshall did not die instantly. He may have left behind the name of the person who took his life. One manner or another. What the fuck is he talking about? What do you mean? What would he have left? This? Doubt it. But otherwise, I have no idea what he's talking about. That's impossible.
Well, Mr. Wright, this is the only possibility left for you. A message from the deceased. Does such a message exist?
Gotta think back to the court record. Real murderer's name that the victim may have left behind. It's in the evidence. I don't know. I'm just gonna try here. This message from the deceased is already in our possession. You're right! You stop at nothing to prove my sister a murderer? Do not be mistaken, Miss Sky.
Our purpose is not to accuse Emma of any crime. There is only one thing we seek. The truth. No matter how painful it may be.
Now then, Mr. Wright, please show us the piece of evidence that conveys a message from the deceased.
I hope I didn't bug. Let's see. It's this. I think it's this.
Take that!
This is the message from the deceased.
Right. Now then, this is the message from the judge!
Damn it! doing so bad at this. Can you jump up already? Something, but what? Bears Emma Sky's prints.
Since from the date if I've ever seen one.
Maybe the autopsy report? Save over this one since it already has like health loss on it anyway. Like it's not gonna. Something like that. In written form, that's the only logical conclusion. Alright, be careful, you might end up being deceased yourself. Let's try this again. Okay. Message from the dead. Written form. I think this is Goodman's though, so it's not that. There isn't much written. Is it the blood on the jar?
Take that!
Oh, okay. Okay. I don't know. I'm fucking guessing. But sure. What the fuck? I mean, yeah. This is that blue badger from before, right?
Oh, is he going to just speak the killer's name? That thing could. I'm sure it would. Looks like everyone's forgotten this is just a jar. The message was left here, on the surface of this jar.
What do you mean?
If you look closely, you can see a faint trail of blood on this jar. It looks like someone wiped the blood away. Yes, but notice. For some reason, blood on some of the fragments was not wiped away.
Oh, you can see where it could form like an E and an M.
Yes.
Yes, there is a line here, drawn in blood.
So what are you saying? Is these dots were once lines? Prosecutor Marshall did not die instantly. He used the few precious moments left to him to leave behind a message. One that someone apparently wiped away. Blood must have seeped into the jar where the lines changed directions. Precisely so. All we need to do is connect those points, and the victim's message will become apparent.
No. Mr. Wright, what kind of message did the victim leave for us?
Your Honor, I believe these bloodstains will reveal to us the answer. I'll connect these dots to make letters. There's only one thing the victim would have written, given the circumstances. His murderer's name.
Oh, do I have to, like, I have to draw it, don't I? Oh, fuck off. Okay. Okay, at least it's, like, oh, I don't have to hold it down. Okay. It's gonna be, okay. Kind of guides you by being like,
"Okay,
is that going to be like an A? So there's going to be some weird reason there's only one M instead of two. It's defense attorney's duty to prove their client's innocence. That's why all I've been thinking about is saving Lana. After all my efforts, I never thought it would turn out like this. Emma. So this is the final message Prosecutor Marshall left behind.
Of all people, he may not have meant it, but in the end, the one who took the victim's life
was Emma Sky. Damn. Seaworthy, can't say I didn't warn. Oh, it's gonna be. I still think. Okay, so. I'm kinda. Okay, it could be just because I totally don't trust Gant or anything. But now I really want to believe more towards the second theory where Gant made it look like it was Emma and used that against Lana. I think. But if it really was Emma that did it, like, damn, I not on this game for committing, but see, not like slamming my gavel just yet. Chief Guns, do you understand the implications of what you've done? What are you talking about? 2 years ago, Joe Dark was sentenced to death. He was convicted because of his final murder. I believe you were the prosecutor in the case, were you not? Ugh! Yes, Worthy. Because of you, an innocent man was sentenced to death. Not only that, but you used forged evidence to ensure his conviction. But Joe Dark really was a serial murderer. That's undeniable. I'm afraid that's not important. Didn't you know? We aren't defenders of justice. What? We're merely keepers of the law. Sentencing a man to death is no light matter. Even if there wasn't any cover-up or evidence forgery. Ultimately, the responsibility falls on the prosecutor in charge. Despite what anyone may say, this fact cannot be denied. Holy shit, prosecutors are awful! What's going on in the prosecutor's office? They might have sentenced a man to his death! Holy shit! How could he just stand there like it wasn't his fault? Those motherfuckers! Order! 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 The gavel's pounding fell on deaf ears. Unable to settle the crowd, the judge declared a recess. Where this trial is headed, no one knows. Really? Oh, damn. Okay. Yep. We're just gonna keep rolling. February 25th, 2006. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 2. Sorry, Edgeworth. I didn't mean to get you in trouble. Don't worry about it. This is my problem, not yours. Hope I'm not interrupting anything, pals! Oh, guess I am. I'll come back later! Wait, Detective Gumshoe, what is it? You've got a lot of nerve, pal. Make a detective run all around while on duty. And to top it off, you call me here? I've seen happier people at funerals. I take it Lana's having you run errands again. Let me tell you, this is the last time, pal. Here, she asked me to give this to you if there was a break in today's trial. Evidence law? talked about this just the other day. You must know the two rules of evidence law. Rule 1, no evidence shall be shown without the approval of the police department. Is that right, Mr. Wright? It seems so. You could at least study some evidence law, really. Yeah, it should be kind of his job. The chief prosecutor also wanted me to give you a message. Message? She said, if you're planning to take him on, you're going to need this book. Him. Gant! Guess I'll need to give this book a thorough read. Evidence law securely slipped into pocket. Doesn't look like that book do you any good now, though. All that's left now is the chief prosecutor's sentence. That's where you're wrong, detective. Huh? Haven't you figured it out yet? Why I'm still sitting in that prosecutor's seat, despite all these allegations that's being thrown at me? Mr. Edgeworth, the real trial today hasn't begun yet. What? What else is there left to do? Your credibility has been all but ruined with this forged evidence you were unaware of. Emma Sky found out she unwittingly caused the man's death, and now you're telling me you want to do more? You've got to be kidding me, pal! You're missing the point, detective. Lana didn't murder Detective Goodman. She merely stuck a knife into his dead body. That means the real killer is still out there. What? We're gonna expose him. No matter what it takes. This case has hurt too many people. It's time to bring it to an end. With 1252, District Court, courtroom number 9. Stupid prosecutors.
Court will now reconvene for the trial of Miss Lana Sky. Mr. Edgeworth?
Yes, Your Honor.
The inquiry committee is planning to impose harsh penalties for your actions.
Thank you for the news, Your Honor. I take it gracefully.
Yes, well, normally this is where the prosecution calls forth a witness. But, this isn't easy to say. You see, there was some concern that you, Miss Edgeworth, may have,
struck a bargain. I think I may have manipulated the witnesses.
I didn't say that. It's just, you see, everyone has been talking, and...
Very well, Your Honor. I have a solution.
A solution?
That being the case, the prosecution will allow the defense to call forth all further witnesses.
What? Well, there's no precedent for what you're proposing.
Undeniably, this is an unusual arrangement, but a very effective one. It would prove that I haven't struck any deals with the witnesses.
Well, Mr. Wright, what do you say?
Unbelievable. Edgeworth has found a way to continue the trial. Very well. The defense accepts the prosecution's proposal of marriage.
Then it's settled. The defense may now call forth the next witness.
Mr. Wright? You do realize this is your last chance? You call the wrong witness. This trial's as good as over. Oh.
I'm getting the hint, Edgeworth. I'm saving.
Defense calls. Time's finally come to bring out the real murderer.
It's totally Angel Starr. I need her ass out here now.
Damon Gant. Defense calls Damon Gant to the stand.
Damon Gant? What does he have to do with anything?
He's the real mastermind. Also, let me check this book while I have the free time. Rules of submitting evidence. No evidence shall be shown without the approval of the police department. Unregistered evidence presented must be relevant to the case on trial. Oh.
Not much of a thorough read I need to do, and it's literally just the one stupid page.
I love the chick on the picture, though. It's so fucking... As the defendant's partner 2 years ago, Mr. Gant has first-hand knowledge of the crime. I feel we should hear what he has to say about it.
As luck would have it, he should still be in the courthouse. He would also be the least likely to have been manipulated by me in any way. Wouldn't you agree, Your Honor?
True. All right. Bailiff, please escort Mr. Grant to the stand.
Witness, please state your name and occupation. What is this, some kind of practical joke? I was just on my way to lunch. Your name and occupation, sir. Worthy, are you sure you want to do this? Your name and occupation. So, you want to play hardball, eh?
Please, Mr. Gant.
Fine. My name is Damon Gant. I'm the acting chief of police. Now then, Chief Gant, the court requests to hear your testimony. All righto. What's with the grim face? First, let's clear up this SL9 incident. Oh, you mean that time when Lana's sister murdered that prosecutor? Personally, I think it's been made pretty clear already. There are still some things unaccounted for. Oh, like what? Like the role you played in all of this. Son, either you're very brave or very foolish. You are aware, of course, that a police chief has all kinds of weapons at his disposal. Weapons? Sure, take my testimony, for example. I don't have to give it if I don't want to. What? Is that true?
I'm afraid so. The chief of police has the right to refuse to testify.
Of course, such an action carries with it certain risks. Don't worry, I'm not here to hinder your trial. Just remember, if this turns out to be a big waste of time, don't say I didn't warn you.
Very well, the witness may now begin his testimony.
SL9 incident. As I recall, Neil and I were questioning him that day. To make a long story short, we slipped up. That power outage didn't help either. When I went to my office, I found Lana there. Apparently she had already arranged the crime scene. As you can see, I had nothing to do with the forgery.
Is that when Dark was arrested?
Him, he was lying on the floor unconscious. When Emma sent Neil flying, it seems Dark bumped his head. How? Where? What?
I see. Everything seems pretty clear-cut.
Where? What? What do you mean? The police chief has the right to refuse to testify. And I better hit him hard and fast.
Okay. I'm not sure what to do here, but we'll figure it out.
As I recall, a ceremony was held at the police department that day. Yes, that's right. I guess you could say I'm a workaholic. After winning his award, Neil was all fired up too. That's probably what spooked Dark and made him run away like that. Was the defendant, Lana Sky, also present in the room? I don't quite remember. At the very least, she wasn't there when Dark ran for it. Long story short, we slipped up the power outage. So the two of you ran immediately after him, right? That's right, but Dark made it to the elevator first. So Neil and I split up. He went upstairs and I went downstairs. I guess you could say, he got lucky. What's this about a power outage? Oh, that! The elevator stopped all of a sudden, and I got the shock of my life. Well, probably not as shocked as Neil was when that knife went into his heart, though. That's just a weird way for someone to talk, like he's
He's so fucking guilty.
It's not funny. When I went to my office, I found Lana there. Did you tell us what you saw? It was a shocking sight.
Yeah, okay, so, okay, now, okay, so that's what the picture looked like. For some reason, he was placed on top of Dark and had the knife in him. Why stack them like that? So that's what I was talking about. The arrangement didn't make sense. Now I'm just even more confused.
You and that serial killer were lying in a heap on the floor, all tangled together. Dark was also lying collapsed on the floor?
Yes, apparently he hit his head and was knocked out.
Next to them were those two poor girls, Lana and Emma. Lana was cradling Emma in her arms. Looking back at it now, she must have already known what her sister had done.
She rearranged the crime scene. How can you know that?
Because of the victim's body. It had already been found.
So that means you found the body near Lana's desk?
That's right. I think you said earlier it was my suit of armor that really stabbed the prosecutor?
Yes.
Anyway,
as you can see, I had nothing to do with the forgery.
So you're saying that the forgery had already taken place by the time you arrived at your office?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
I can understand how Lana must have felt. But moving a body and hiding evidence are inexcusable, no matter what the circumstances. Is that how it really went down?
Staring at the witness won't get you any good. Won't do you any good, Mr. Wright.
If you're going to stare at anything, you're better off staring at the core record.
Hint, hint.
Were they? Always a smooth talker.
Which piece of evidence ties Gant to the forgery? Lana did admit to forging evidence. That can't be the whole truth. Somehow, I've got to lead Gant to the incident.
Okay. Hold on. Let me save. Oops.
What evidence would tie him? Let's see. Found in Chief Gant's safe.
Oh, because this is in his safe with Emma's evidence on it. Okay. Yeah, I see this. Okay, so this is where I had nothing to do with it. Okay, cool. Can you explain what was in your safe then?
If you really had nothing to do with the forgery, then how do you explain this?
What's that? What's that on it? A handprint?
Chief Gant, your explanation, please.
I don't know. You tell me, son.
Huh?
My dear Raito, don't you know the second rule of evidence law?
Uh-oh, not this again. Evidence law.
Rule number 2. Unregistered evidence presented must be relevant to the case on trial. Tell me, how is that rag relevant to this trial?
It appears the defense was not prepared.
This is too early to use this piece of evidence.
Please accept my profound apologies, Chief. Do you mind giving the defense another chance?
Well, okay, I'll do it just this once, but only because you asked, Aji.
Thank you. I assure you the defense is terribly sorry.
Okay, so that's why they're telling me pay attention to the evidence law. Got it.
Yeah, sorry to nail you.
Okay, so let's check this again. Notice shall be shown without the approval of the police department. Unregistered evidence presented must be relevant to the case on trial. Okay, so it has to be relevant to the case, and it has to have been approved. What ties him to the case? This has been accepted, so I think present this. No, this.
Damn it, that was my only, like, real guess.
Okay, I'm sorry. I know it's probably, like, not fun to have me look up guides, but I just... Wait, but I did present it. What do you... Oh, did I present it at the wrong spot? I must have presented it at the wrong spot. I think I must have presented it in the wrong spot. Okay, so it is this. I just presented it in the wrong place. My bad. You claim you had nothing to do with the forgery. But I'm afraid that is a claim you cannot back up. Explain yourself. Several pieces of evidence were found in your office. Take this jar, for example.
That's that blue badger you showed us earlier.
A piece of this jar was discovered in your safe. Not only that, but the evidence list I presented earlier.
Oh. See, I got stuck on the fact that it's now Emma's picture that I completely forgot that it was hidden in his locker.
It was actually found inside. Oh, this one was found inside the desk. Duh. Oh my word. That's why you want to play this game like in one day. Or at least the cases, like the episodes. Yes.
It was found where?
You see, Chief Gant, these articles of evidence uncovered in your office are both concrete proof that you also played a part in the illegal investigation.
Chief Gant! What's the meaning of this?
Oh, here's a defense attorney who may even rival Worthy. So you admit to it then, that you were involved in the forgery?
Who, me? Or do you mean you?
Me? How would I have anything to do with that?
Well, you were the one who snuck into my office when you found this evidence.
Prosecutors aren't the only ones capable of forging evidence, you know. Defense attorneys can do so too. Isn't that right, Raito?
You do not talk slander towards my boyfriend!
However, Detective Gumshoe was present during the investigation. Worthy? Oh, sorry.
Worthy, my boy. Not even detectives are exempt from the law. Rest assured, Dick will receive his due punishment.
What? Detective Gumshoe's salary drops any further, he'll be paying to work.
Yes, well, in light of the detective's presence, please give us your testimony regarding these pieces of evidence found in your office, and in relation to the forgery that took place at the crime scene.
My. Kids these days no longer know how to put two and two together.
Evidence and forgery. Let's see. What was it now? A jar fragment and this list? For all I know, you could have planted them in my office. Anyway, you can't prove when
those pieces of evidence were discovered. If they were found after Dark was convicted, then they're worthless. There's no reason I'd participate in a forgery. Rearranging the crime scene wouldn't help me out in any way. Shit, I don't know what the fuck to do with that.
Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor?
When investigating the crime scene, you should have been more careful to observe protocol.
You do understand that I am the chief of police, right? There will be consequences. Indeed, I believe I will press charges, so you won't make the same mistake again.
My apologies, Chief, but Witcher might wait until tomorrow for that. Today is, well, you know.
All right, Aji. In return, though.
I know. That place, right?
Huh? What are these guys, telepathic? Okay. You could have planted them in my office. Anyway, you can't prove when those pieces of evidence were discovered. They were found after Dark was convicted, then they're worthless. No reason I'd participate in a forgery. Rearranging the crime scene wouldn't help me out in it. Really, Chief Gant? At the very least, there is one very large benefit you've reaped from all this. Oh, I wasn't aware. What is this benefit? That would, of course, be the position you have. Chief of Police.
Oh!
Resolution of the SL9 incident secured your promotion to Chief. That in itself is sufficient motive. Oh, that's a good one. Huh? Do you really think I'm that incompetent? What do you mean? Even without that case, I was already in line to become the next chief. The resolution of SL9 merely sped up the inevitable a little. Is that true, Edgeworth? Yes. He was going to be made chief anyway. Ha! Be careful when pointing that finger, or you might wind up being the one pointed at. So that means there's only one possible motivation for you to commit forgery. If you didn't do it for yourself, then you did it for someone else. Don't be silly, Worthy. You know me better than that. There are only three people I look out for. Me, myself, and I. There, it's out in the open now. Aji, would you mind if I change my testimony a little?
By all means, please do.
I wouldn't be anyone's accomplice if there was nothing in it.
Hold it!
Nothing in it for you? Sorry, but the only person I care about is yours truly. That girl, Mona's little sister, was it? If you think I felt sorry for her, you'd better think again. Alright, you don't feel sorry for anyone. Be tough on crime and tough on people. That's how I was raised. You seem to be lax enough on yourself, though. That was a good one, Worthy. Been something in for him? In a selfishness, would he have helped someone out? True, you might not help out anyone for their sake, but it would benefit you. But if it would benefit you, you might decide to assist someone.
Mr. Wright, it appears you're positively determined to portray the chief as a nice man who likes to lend people a hand.
That's not what I mean.
Very well then, who is this person you believe Chief Gant may have helped forge evidence? Chief Prosecutor Lana Skye? The defendant?
I believe it's quite obvious in light of the circumstances. Emma Skye fell victim to an unfortunate series of events. Who would want to help her more than her own sister, Lana? And as for Chief Gant, he would also have a reason to help Lana if she asked him to. That reason, of course, is self-profit.
itself, Prophet? What do you mean?
After the SL9 incident was resolved, Lana Sky was appointed chief prosecutor at the prosecutor's office. The person who arranged this job change was you, Chief Gant.
But how would he profit from all of this?
He would be able to use the chief prosecutor as his puppet. Essentially, he would acquire unchecked authority over all investigations.
Do you mean to tell me that despite the chief's formidable appearance, he plays with puppets?
Oh boy.
Oh, wait. You must mean puppet as in someone forced to do his bidding. Never mind!
Admit it, Chief. You assisted Lana Sky in forging evidence. Your motive? To appoint her as chief prosecutor so you could control her.
Righto, my boy. You have quite an imagination. Let me ask you something.
What?
Do you have any proof of this? That I controlled Lana? For example, is Lana testifying that I've done such a thing?
She's keeping quiet to protect Emma. There's no way she'd testify against Gant.
I'm afraid without any proof, this all amounts to nothing more than mere conjecture.
Unless that is also what happened in this incident.
This incident? Which one would that be?
Of course I'm talking about the murder of Detective Bruce Goodman. The chief prosecutor has been acting strange throughout this entire trial. Almost as if someone has been controlling her.
Worthy, you'd better watch your tongue. I wouldn't want you to get hurt.
Just what do you mean?
What he means, Your Honor, is that Chief Gant is involved in the murder of Detective Goodman. Not only that, but the chief is now making Lana take the rap to cover up his involvement.
What? Order! 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 I said order!
I just sort of realized something. So, you know how, well, okay, maybe you don't. On Streamlabs, it says I went live, correct? Twitch, however, this whole time, and I've been a dumbass to not notice, has said I'm not live. So I've basically just been recording and have not been live at all this whole time. And I had no idea. That's fucking weird that, like, I was having connection issues earlier when trying to stream. Why would it not work? Oh. You didn't have to do it. Oh.
Mr. Wright, you can't be serious.
Huh?
This is an affront to the highest ranking officer in our law enforcement agency. To accuse the chief of police of blackmail and murder? That's impossible!
Wow, Judge really lost his shit, huh?
Your Honor, I was merely reiterating what Mr. Edgeworth said in easier to understand language.
My boy. It's too late, Mr. Wright. There's no turning back for us now.
It's you and me, baby, all the way. All the way. That's my boo-boo.
Looks like he's the one who's decided to go through with this.
Shit. Alright, I need to go back to streamer manager. You know.
It looks like he's the one who's decided to go through with this.
Can you prove this, Mr. Wright?
that the chief, a high-ranking officer of the law, is involved in this murder?
Good question.
Regardless of his rank or title, Chief Gant is just a man. The question is he a criminal? I believe the evidence will tell.
Or she? Alright, then. My health bar has popped up. That means I need to do something correctly. Let's see what Mr. Wright's got. And it better be good. Show us this evidence that this ties Chief Gant to the murder of Detective Goodman. Okay.
Oh, it's gonna be the thingy. It's gonna be this. And it's been accepted as evidence. And whatever the other rule was. I think it's been approved by police to be used. I think. I hope. I think this is it.
This is the ID card list.
Yes, the one that shows who entered the evidence room on the day of the crime. There was one ID on the list we couldn't determine the owner of yesterday. 777-7777. Sorry, but there's no way you can prove that's my card number. It's your number.
Oh. What? How do you know that?
The safe in Chief Gant's office requires a code to open. A 7-digit code.
7 digits? You don't mean...
I'm afraid so, Your Honor. The code was 777-7777. The same as the remaining ID card number on that list.
Gant, you've entered the evidence room on the day of the crime.
I like seeing you nervous, Gant.
Order, order! Chief Gant, what do you have to say?
Nothing. The defense's search of my office was in violation of regulations. And I will demand Mr. Wright to be punished to the maximum extent of the law. For right now, this court demands an explanation from you about the use of this ID card.
Chief Gant, so you admit it? You entered the evidence room? On the day of the crime?
What about it? I'm chief of police, whether it's the evidence room or the bathroom. What's the difference? I can go anywhere I want. Tell me, when you entered the room, were you alone? I always go to the bathroom alone, as I do with the evidence room. Detective Goodman wouldn't have happened to be with you that day, would he?
Of course not. Why would he be?
I hadn't seen him in days. You hadn't seen him in days? Chief Gant, I'm afraid you've just undone yourself. On that day, you had to have met with Detective Goodman.
What do you mean? This trial's purpose is to determine Lana Skye's guilt.
No, it isn't, Your Honor. This trial's purpose is to determine the truth. Chief Gant met with the victim on the day of the crime. Then we need to determine one thing. What transpired during the meeting?
In that case, Mr. Wright, we're going to ask for evidence. Show us proof that the victim went to meet Chief Gant on the day of the crime.
Fuck, I don't know. Would it be... this? It could either be this or this. Or the award. I think they would have seen each... well, I think they went to see each other because of the case, but I don't know how to prove that. Past recipients are etched on the plate. May have heard of our Commerce Bear producer too. How ironic. Oh, that's kind of cool. I never noticed that.
don't think that's what I want. I think it's gonna be this. Or... for this? I mean... can only be submitted to the chief of police. Okay, maybe this. Detective Goodman lost his ID card on the day of the crime. Or to be more accurate, Jake Marshall stole it. So Detective Goodman filled out a lost item report. He would have had to give that report to the chief of police. Yet you are in possession of the report. Which means you can't be sure if he filed it. He filed it. How do I know, you ask? Because he needed to enter the evidence room that day.
In your turn?
Yes, to transfer the evidence out.
Oh!
Hey, exonerator! Detective Oh. Thank you! I really like the new emotes too. I can actually commission a new one thanks to a very generous person who bought gift subs. So now I have to figure out a new emote already. Yes, thank you again, Jesse. If you guys have suggestions for a new emote, let me know. Detective Goodman took the form to you, Chief Gant. Then, you accompanied the detective to the evidence room. I accompanied him? There's no other way to the murderer and Detective Goodman could have entered the room. Holy shit, he might have a point. Hold on, let me guess what you're going to say next. I, the chief of police, murdered poor Goodman. Exactly. Yeah.
Which ways?
The chief didn't necessarily need to accompany him to the evidence room. You could have just lent him his ID card. Judge, don't help him out. Shush. Shush your old man mouth. Yes. Now that you mention it, I believe I might have done something of the sort. Judge Nina had to talk. Yes. My laptop blue screen, but oh no! Oh, the blue screen of death. I remembered from my early years. I used to have that shit happen a lot, especially when I was playing. I think it was Sims 2. I almost had Sims 3, but I'm pretty sure it was the Sims 2 because I had a lot of expansion packs and stuff. But also, I think. Because what would happen, and I've been paranoid of this since, so I don't do it anymore. What I used to do is, like, I'd play for a while. Like, you would save and stuff. Like, I'd sometimes save, but I wasn't really good at, like, I wasn't up on it all the time. So then I would, like, but then, like, so, I like, I paused the game, and I would, like, go to the bathroom, go grab a snack, talk to someone in my household or something. And then I'd come back, and if I had been gone for more than, like, say a couple minutes, let's say a few minutes, I get the blue screen of death. I'd have to reboot my computer, and if I was dumb, I didn't save, so I probably lost an hour or so of progress in The Sims, and I had to redo shit, and I did it often enough where I knew it's because I had The Sims paused for too long. With no, like, movement or action. So, I've learned now to save often and don't leave it paused for too long. I don't think it happens with the newer games. I'm not sure about 3. I don't think so with 4, though. At least I haven't seen it yet. But still, it's... it was an experience. Sorry, but that's not possible. Exclamation mark? According to the record, your card was only used once.
Yet you showed us your ID card earlier. You had really lent it to Detective Goodman. It would have been found on his body.
Oh, shit! I was not expecting that as his critical spray. He went fucking Saiyan.
Chief Gunt! You didn't! You didn't just go Saiyan in my courtroom, did you, champ?
Judge, I can explain.
The murder was most likely a spur of the moment crime, or no one in their right mind would choose the police department as a place to commit murder.
That's what I love about the Phoenix Wright games. It's like the different sprites, and like always the best looking ones are the ones where like they're like, it's the, I call it the critical sprite, but it's basically when they're like super stressed or super guilty or like super caught in something, you know, they're a liar or whatever. And it's just, they're always great without fail.
After the murder, you contacted Lana at the prosecutor's office. Why? To dispose of Detective Goodman's body, of course.
You're forgetting, Mr. Wright, that the victim's body was discovered in the prosecutor's office's parking lot. How did he manage to move it there?
I was at the police department the entire day, you know. And everyone's aware that Lana stayed at the prosecutor's office after the ceremony. Everyone except me, it seems. Still, you're the chief of police. You have an entire police force at your disposal.
Oh, so you think I just ordered an officer to do it?
Hey, you! Take this here dead body over to the prosecutor's office.
I don't think so.
Chief Gant, you left all the evidence we need. Prove how you moved the body to the prosecutor's office. And all this time, I thought it was a useless clue, just taking up space. Is it gonna be the fucking badger? Is it gonna be the fucking badger? It's gonna be the badger. It's gonna be the fucking blue badger. Holy fuck. It's gonna be the blue badger. As soon as he said, oh, I thought it was just gonna take up space. No. No.
How could the chief have moved the body? Mr. Wright, show us this evidence.
To move the victim's body, Chief can't use this.
Holy shit, that's correct. What?
Well?
I see.
Exactly.
Maybe I'll use this later. To move your dead body, Mr. Wright.
Huh?
And I'll help you dispose of it. Wait! No! I was... The game tricked me!
How dare! How dare!
The music stopped! That's always my cue that I got it right!
This game's being mean to me.
I feel betrayed! Okay, what the fuck did he use? Actually, then, if not that. I don't think I have evidence. What do you mean? What are they talking about? They're talking about Edward's car. I don't got it. Maybe the gloves. I'm kind of... But, like, I feel like the idea is, like... I mean, the gloves is the next best guess. My only confusion is, like, the whole idea is, like... Oh, like, how did he move the body without being seen? But there's nothing big enough. That's why I thought it was going to be the stupid blue badger. Because it's like, oh, what if he, like, hid it somehow in the mechanism or something weird? I mean, let's try the glove. I don't know.
And if this doesn't work...
I guess that was it.
You know what? I think because it was sticking out of a locker at one point when we found it, or it fell somehow. So, yeah, okay. I guess I can see how that works. It sounded like they were implying, like, they used something, like, big to conceal it, the body. Not like, oh, how did you, like, pick up the body and go? Okay. Well, I see. Maybe I'll use this later to move your dead body, Mr. Wright. He likes to threaten me. I think we're on the right track. Huh? Wait, no. Okay, no, so that means I was wrong. Okay. Guide, Listen, today's been a day. I don't got time. The screwdriver? What does the screwdriver have to do with anything? Hold on. Oh! Brought back to his office by Gantz with Quest. Okay, this is convoluted as fucking hell for them to expect me... Well, okay, I guess it's not that far of a stretch. But because it's been multiple days since... This case has been dragged on for multiple days, like, in real life for me. I forgot. So this screwdriver, he had given it to Edgeworth and told him, hey, I want you to hold this at your office. And so they had used Edward's car to stash Gant's body. So there's, okay, so what the game wanted me to connect was, okay, we know it was in Edward's car, but what would make Edward drive back to his office? Instead of, I guess the fact that he would have had to gone back to work. But anyway. He specifically grabbed this piece of evidence and went to Edgeworth and was like, hey, please take this back to your office. I want you to hold on to this for me. And that's what got Edgeworth to move from the police station to the prosecutor's office with a dead body in his trunk. Okay. I kind of get it now. Okay. It's a fucking stretch and not at all where I was thinking, but sure. Especially with the way he was like, oh, I thought this was just taking up space, this piece of evidence. It's a fucking screwdriver. What does it matter?
What's that? A screwdriver? And what does that have to do with this case?
Mr. Edgeworth, think back to the day of the crime. What is the screwdriver doing here?
It's here because... I was asked to go. By Chief Gantz, no less. He told me he wanted me to keep it here in the prosecutor's office. In any case, on the day of the stabbings, I brought this back here. After the ceremony ended that day, I didn't plan to return to the... Okay. That answered my question earlier. I didn't plan to return to the prosecutor's office. But you did, because Chief Gantz asked you to.
You mean I...
The body was found in the trunk of Mr. Edward's car. I think it's obvious what happened. Body was moved by that car.
We knew that, though! That wasn't a debate!
Wait, was it?
Yeah, we established earlier that's how his body was moved.
Oh, good grief. Okay.
Detective Griffin's body carried in the trunk of Mr. Edward's car!
Yes, unless, of course, you have another explanation, Chief.
Why else would you have asked Mr. Edgeworth to transport evidence from a closed case?
There's only one plausible explanation. Transport the body to your accomplice, Miss Lana Skye.
Order!
What's going on here?
Oh, nice. Sorry that server got hacked, though. Damn.
Is there no room for rebuttal to the defense's outrageous accusations?
Think back to the photograph Miss Starr took at the prosecutor's office. This was not a photo of the body being stuffed in the trunk to be taken away. This is the first time we're actually discussing how the body was moved from the police station to the prosecutor's office. Okay. For some reason, no one thought of this earlier. We were talking about how he died at the police station. But... okay, now it's actually being explained. Okay. Oh, nice. Like a good old isekai situation. It was exactly the opposite. It is a photo of the body being taken from the trunk.
Chief Gunt, please say something.
I believe your time's up.
My time's up?
Sorry, Raito, but I'm having lunch with the District Attorney General after this. We have to get going if we're to make it in time for the early bird special. But cross-examination isn't finished yet. Remember what I told you earlier? A police chief has all kinds of weapons at his disposal. Weapons? Like the right to refuse to testify. I'm invoking that right now.
What? That is not a right to be casually invoked. There are certain risks to be considered.
So you're going to just run away after all this? Run away? Don't make me laugh, Worthy. I stabbed old Goodman. That's what you're saying, right? But if you had any conclusive evidence, you would have presented it by now. Well, I think I had Lana dispose of the body. If so, then show your proof and get it over with.
I'll say it again, Mr. Wright. Main Gunt is the current chief of police. This court will not tolerate any accusations against him without concrete proof. Well, Mr. Wright?
Your Honor?
Do you have any concrete proof? Proof that Chief Gunt murdered Detective Goodman and made Miss Guy dispose of his body.
I have concrete proof. I
saw it earlier when I was looking at the guide for something else, but I think I have to say I have no proof yet. Let me double check. I know this is annoying though. I'm like, oh, you're using a guide, blah, blah, blah. You should figure it out for yourself. But you know what? After my ordeal with streaming, fuck it. This is how I take care of myself. Thank you. This is my form of self-care right now. Until I can be done streaming. Oh no, it's not you, Exonerator, but I imagine there are people who are like... I've seen it on other people's, like, either walkthroughs or on other people's streams where they're like, oh, you're using a guide. You should be going in blind and trying to figure it out yourself or something. I'm like... even if people think that way with my shit, I don't care. I don't want it. Thanks. No use showing evidence I'm not even sure of myself. No, Your Honor. At present, I have no conclusive evidence. See, Angie?
In that case, this court is forced to penalize you for your allegations against the chief.
What? Here's a tip. Never gamble what you can't afford to lose, Raito. It seems that Lady Luck was on my side again today. Okay, Aji, I'll leave the rest to you. Please. Fuck, did I really... is that it? That's it, isn't it? Oh, fuck. I warned you earlier... oh, sorry.
I warned you earlier, Mr. Wright. This... an affront to the senior officer in our nation's law enforcement agency.
Ah!
the game really go, hey, we're going to make you think you fucked up. Here's the health bar. And then have Edgeworth save our ass and get rid of them. Game. The fake out. Oh my God. This episode is full of fake outs and I hate it, but also love it. Lady Luck, maybe we should have a word with her.
Mr. Edgeworth, what do you mean?
There's one lady who knows the real truth behind this trial. Lana. Oh, is Lana going to finally tell the truth? We haven't yet had the honor of hearing her testimony. A lady who knows the truth. Another witness. In the absence of conclusive evidence, the only other method of proof is testimony. But Chief Gand has invoked his right to refuse to testify. There's still someone else. One more witness who can answer all the questions raised in this trial. Someone right in this very room.
Mr. Edgeworth, who is this person?
Should be obvious, Judge. Why are you asking me, Your Honor? Have you forgotten? The defense is the one calling witnesses today.
Mr. Wright, does such a witness exist?
She may not be willing to tell the truth. We can't just stop now. Yes, Your Honor. Defense calls forth. Lana!
Take that. The defendant? Miss Lana Sky?
She was in the underground parking lot at 5:15 p.m. on February 21st. Her task? To dispose of the victim's body. In accordance with a certain someone's orders.
Mr. Edgeworth?
Prosecution has no objections, Your Honor.
Very well. The court will now take its final recess for the day. In 15 minutes, we will reconvene to hear the defendant's testimony. This court is now in re...
Hold on.
Huh?
Chief Gunt! I thought you were going to eat! He doesn't want her to talk. I wonder why. Listen good, Lana. He's talking to Lana. I don't think you need me to tell you this, but if you accept Mr. Wright's claims, there will be terrible consequences. This is clearly threats towards a witness. This is not legal, at least in the U.S. court. If someone is threatening, like, a witness or a defendant or, like anyone, if there are threats made, you would be in trouble. He clearly said to a witness in front of everyone, hey, if you talk, there will be terrible consequences. How is this accepted in this witness tampering? Yes, thank you. Why in this fictional court would this be allowed? The judge is too stupid to be a judge because he's not calling out any of this shit. Ha! That's right. Your sister will be found guilty for Neil Marshall's murder. Ah! This isn't good! Of course, you never support such outrageous claims anyway. Right? Just something to think about. Alright then. I've got a lunch date to meet! Oh, all this threatening of people makes me so hungry!
Okay. There aren't any further objections or threats. This court is now in recess.
I mean, it's the statute of limitations. Wait, no, but it's a closed case. I don't think they can find her guilty anymore, can they? It's considered closed. Unless they file it as something else. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not anyone who deals with law. But if a case is closed, I don't think double jeopardy. I don't know. Isn't double jeopardy like you can't accuse? Yeah, like you can't accuse a person twice, I believe, is how double jeopardy works.
Right, yeah, you can't be tried. So, but the problem is she was never tried for it to begin with. It was the murderer, the serial murderer, who was tried and convicted and executed for the crime. Unless new evidence comes forward. But, like, but does that apply for if it's a different person you're convicting? I thought that only applied if you're convicting the same person. Because the whole point of double jeopardy is so people have a right to, once they're found not guilty, they don't have to live in fear for the rest of their lives of being tried again and again and again. There's appeals, but I think that's different. So it's meant to protect the person who was found not guilty. However, Emma was never accused of it at all. So I guess the argument is, can you try someone for a case that's legally closed? Can they reopen that case and file a new case, but against a new person? Appeals are usually about saying the process of justice wasn't executed well, but also if there's new evidence or testimony. Okay, usually no. Yeah, so, I mean, granted, there is new evidence. And there is new testimony for the old case. That's still weird, though. Man, I wish, like, Legal Eagle or Emily D. Baker was here just so we'd be like, hi, you're professionals. Explain, please. Because I'm not that professional. I am not that person. Can't open it, Gales. Yeah, true. I know this is, like, fictional. Like, this is a fictional court system. Nah. Oh, gosh. Yeah, too. That's a whole other thing. Each state sees it differently. Most of them, like, most stuff is, like, pretty, like, straightforward. But certain states have different things. Oh, gosh. That's a whole other thing. Nah, it's okay. It's interesting discussions to think about. I don't know, like, it's so funny. My dad's like, are you trying to be a lawyer? I keep hearing you talk about lawyers and law stuff. And I'm like, I don't know. I don't want to be a lawyer. I would be terrible as a lawyer. But I find it so fascinating. I don't know why. Like, I love listening to lawyers. I love listening to cases and trials. Like, it's so interesting. Recently, I watched on Netflix The 12, which is a Flemish, I think it's a Belgian show. They speak Flemish and I think also French too, though. But it's about this person who is on trial, and they pick how that court system works is that they pick 12 jurors, and so the story revolves around not only the person who's on trial and the people involved in the case itself, but also revolves around the jurors themselves. And you kind of see their point of view, their backgrounds, their own dramas they're going through, and how it all converges to the end of this case of whether or not this woman is guilty for two separate murders, I believe. Yeah, it was two separate murders. Mostly real estate and contract law. My dad is malpractice of medicine mostly. Oh! Malpractice is so interesting too. About a criminal lawyer is getting them to explain murder in the second and voluntary manslaughter. Yeah, like the distinctions between like all the different labels. Yeah, it's just wild.